There are new intimate details of a reported relationship between a president, his brother, and a Hollywood sex symbol. 11 boxes of files Hollywood spy slash private eye Fred O'Tash socked away in a storage unit in the San Fernando Valley were reviewed by the Hollywood Reporter.
This was someone who had wiretaps all over town, was listening to some of the biggest stars, and an era when some of these revelations would be published in magazines.
Matt Bellany is the executive editor for The Hollywood Reporter.
O'Tash claims that he had recordings of JFK having sex with Marilyn Monroe. He spoke about this as if it was a common knowledge thing.
O'Tash worked for members of Hollywood's elite to dig up dirt on their enemies. In notes he left behind before his death, reviewed by The Hollywood Reporter, O'Tash provides salacious details of the long-rumored affairs between Marilyn Monroe and both President John F. Kennedy and his brother Robert Kennedy. He claims he listened to Marilyn Monroe having sex with John F. Kennedy. And in the hours before her death, O'Tash says Monroe had a blowout fight with Bobby Kennedy over their relationship. He claims Monroe complained she was being passed around like a piece of meat. O'Tash claims he heard Bobby Kennedy trying to quiet Monroe down with a pillow so neighbors wouldn't hear her shouting. But the audio tapes his notes are based on have since disappeared.
Some of these files that we reviewed contain elements that are not 100% verifiable. They are his recollections and his recollections to his daughter. So, you know, what he said and what his actual truth is not necessarily the same.
O'Tash was part of the LAPD until 1955 after a falling out with the police chief, so he became gumshoe to the stars. O'Tash disguised a surveillance van as a TV repair truck. The real-life gumshoe helped inspire the fictional detective Jack Nicholson portrayed in the film noir classic Chinatown.
There are lots of guys like J.J. Gittes.
He was someone who naturally moved in Hollywood circles and also kind of in the gray zone between the police, the mob, the private investigators who made Hollywood in the 1950s such an interesting place.
Now, O'Tash's daughter said she released all that information to The Hollywood Reporter because she thought her father's reputation was being maligned.